Hello, everybody. My name is Andrew Crust. I am the music director of your Lima Symphony Orchestra. I hope you are all comfortable on your favorite chair or a big comfy couch, and you're ready to listen to some beautiful music and learn with me today. Welcome to Meet the Family. Now, I'm not talking about meeting your mom and dad and aunts and uncles and cousins. I'm talking about our musical family. Now, what on earth do I mean by that? Well, when we're talking about the instruments of the orchestra, we group them into families. Four families, to be exact. How many families of instruments can you name? Go ahead, say them if you know them. If you're having a little trouble, I'll give you one for free. Strings. How about the other three? Very good. The four families of instruments are strings, brass, woodwinds, and percussion. Today, the members of our Lima Symphony Musical Orchestra family are going to give us a special tour of all of their instruments and play some beautiful music. And just like any other family drama, there's going to be a few surprises along the way. The largest instrument family in the orchestra is the strings. You can think of them as all those cousins you have who live all around the country in Columbus and California and Chicago and Phoenix. There are lots of them, and they are split into five different groups. Come with me, let's go and meet the strings. Welcome to the string family. Don't worry, they don't bite. Well, most of them don't. As I said, the string family is divided into five sections. We have first violins, second violins, violas, cellos, and string basses. Why are there so many members of the string family compared to the other families? Well, one single trumpet can play as loud as a couple dozen violins, and so we need a lot of strings to produce a big, warm sound. Before we meet each instrument individually, let's hear some music. This is a piece of music by American composer Aaron Copland called Hoe-Down from his piece Rodeo. Maybe this will make you think of cowboys dancing out in a Wild West town. And if you feel like dancing, go ahead and do that at home. Wasn't that fantastic? Now, let's meet the members of the string family. We'll go from smallest to largest. The smallest string instrument is this one. Can you tell me what it is? Very good, violin. Every string instrument has four strings. They're made of wood, and the bow they pull across the strings is made from, get this, horsehair. But don't worry, it doesn't hurt the horse at all. It's just like getting a haircut. And that hair ends up making beautiful music. Now, the principal, or first chair violin, is called the concertmaster, and they are the leaders of the orchestra. Our concertmaster is going to play us a little excerpt so we can hear the violin all by itself. I mentioned that stringed instruments are made of wood, horsehair, and metal strings. Did you know that some people own stringed instruments that were made in the 1600s? That's about 400 years ago, almost 200 years before America was even a country. The next instrument in the string family is the viola. As you will see, the viola is shaped like a violin and played under the chin like the violin, but it's a little larger than the violin. If it's larger, do you think the sound will be higher or lower? Very good job. The larger the instrument is, the lower the sound. Our principal viola is going to play us a little excerpt so we can hear how the viola sounds. Isn't that a gorgeous instrument? It's a deeper, darker sound, closer to the human voice. Before we meet the final two members of the string family, let's hear some more music. We've seen how string players can make music by pulling or pushing the bow across a string. There's another way that they can produce a sound without a bow at all. Have you ever plucked or strummed a guitar or maybe a ukulele? Well, you can do that on these instruments as well, but we call it pizzicato. Can you say that after me? Pizzicato. Very good. Here is a little tune called Playful Pizzicato, written by British composer Benjamin Britten. Thank you. Okay, we've got two more family members to meet. Up next is the cello. As you can see, we are getting larger and larger. The cello is so large, our principal cellist couldn't possibly put it under their chin to play, so it sits on the floor. Cellos are made of the same stuff that violins and violas are made of, but they have something called an end pin, which sticks out of the bottom of the instrument and helps it sit on the floor. Our principal cellist is going to play us a little demonstration now so we can hear the cello all alone. Last, but certainly not least, we have the largest of all of the stringed instruments. So large, I bet many of you could fit inside. This is the string bass. If it's the largest instrument in the family, it's also the lowest. And the bass gets to play the bass line, which is kind of like the conductor of a train. The bass line drives the orchestra. Let's listen to our principal bass as they show us what the string bass can do. Now we've met our entire string family. Let's hear some music to celebrate all of this new knowledge. This piece you're about to hear is called Signs of Life 2 by Russell Peck.
Thank you.
Okay, time to meet the next instrument family. This one is impossible to define because it includes so many different kinds of instruments. You wouldn't be able to count all of the different kinds of instruments. The percussion family includes any instrument you can strike, pluck, shake, or scrape. They might have pitches or they might not. They may be made of metal, wood, plastic, bone, stone, or anything else that makes a sound. Let's dive in. We're going to hear some music from our Lima Symphony Orchestra percussion section. This piece has a funny name. It's called Omphalo Centric Lecture by composer Nigel Westlake. It features four of the same instrument, which we call marimba. It's a cousin of the xylophone, which you probably have heard of. A marimba is struck with mallets which have felt tips, and one percussionist can play with as many as four mallets at one time. A marimba has wooden bars which the percussionist strikes with the mallet and big metal resonating tubes underneath to amplify the sound. Enjoy. Thank you. Wasn't that amazing? Now, let's have a closer look at some of the other instruments in the percussion family. Our LSO principal percussion, Jim Lehman, is going to take us on a little tour of some of these instruments. Jim?
Hello, this is the Lima Symphony percussion section. We're going to start off by demonstrating a few instruments. This is called the timpani. Use this in a lot of the literature we play. Timpani is a unique kind of instrument as compared to the rest of the drones because it can play different pitches. So we can actually tune the drum to whatever kind of, you know, pitch we need, depending on what we're playing. Then we'll demonstrate just a few other things that we have for you today. Some wooden instruments. We have the castanets. These are paddle castanets. These are the claves. Down the row. Okay, then we'll do the tambourine next. Tambourine you can play by hitting it or shaking it to jingle or use your fingers or thumb. Then we have some metal sounding instruments for you today. The first one is, of course, the triangle. And next, we have some crash cymbals. Usually heard at the loud moments in the orchestra. And then we also used a different kind of cymbal called a suspended cymbal, okay, for crescendos and things like that. You can also play it with a stick. And there you have, that's just some of the percussion section.
Thank you, Jim, and thank you to all of our percussionists. Now, let's hear one more piece of music featuring our percussion quartet. This one is called Partials by composer Alan Keown, which uses bass drums and bongos. Up next, let's meet another family of instruments, the woodwind family. Now, this one is a little confusing because even though they have wood in the name, they're not all made of wood. Some are, but some aren't. We'll get to that later. But wind, they all use wind. Woodwind players use their breath to create the sound. Do you know how to whistle? Then you're already a woodwind player. Do you know how to make a sound from a bottle by blowing air across the top? That also makes you a woodwind player. Welcome to the woodwinds. There are four main instruments in the woodwind family. We have the flute and its smaller cousin, the piccolo. Then we have the oboe and its larger cousin, the English horn. We have the clarinet and its larger cousin, the bass clarinet. And finally, the bassoon and its larger cousin, the contrabassoon. Let's begin with some music. This one you might recognize. This one is In the Hall of the Mountain King by Grieg. Let's meet each member of the family. First up is the flute. The modern flute is made of metal, sometimes gold or platinum even. But the flute is one of the oldest instruments in history. For thousands of years, people have been carving flutes out of wood or stone or even bone. To make a sound, you blow across a hole on the top of the instrument, just like you do with a bottle. And you use your fingers to lengthen or shorten the tube, creating higher or lower sounds. Our LSO principal flute is going to give you a little taste of the flute sound now. Up next, we have the oboe, which is made of wood and metal and uses what is called a double reed. That's two pieces of cane strapped together. The oboist uses their breath and their lips to buzz these two pieces of cane together, which make a beautiful sound. The cane has to be just right, moist and a really good quality to create a perfect sound. Our LSO oboist is going to show us the beautiful tone of the oboe now. Let's hear some more music now before we meet our final two members of the woodwind family. Do any of you like Harry Potter? I thought so. This is a piece from Harry Potter called Nimbus 2000 by composer John Williams. Let's meet our final two woodwinds now. The clarinet is a lot like the oboe. It's made of wood and uses a reed, but a single reed, not a double-strapped reed together. The clarinet is used in many different styles, from classical to jazz to klezmer music and so much more. Our principal clarinet is going to give you a little demo now. And finally, the bassoon. The bassoon is the largest of the woodwind instruments. Based on what we learned about cello and bass, do you think the bassoon will be higher or lower than the clarinet? Very good. It's the lowest member of the woodwind family. Just like the oboe, the bassoon uses a double reed. It can play both high and low, and you might even say it sounds like a human voice. Our principal bassoon is going to give us a little demo now. Thank you. are now going to play one more piece of music for you today. You know how the letter Y can sometimes be a vowel? Well, the French horn can sometimes join the woodwind section because its sound goes so well with them. So we're going to invite some of our French horn players for this excerpt from Richard Strauss's Serenade for Winds. Now, there's only one family left. We've heard woodwinds, percussion, and strings. What's the last one? Can you tell me? Very good. The last one is the brass family. Well, based on the name, I think you could probably tell me what these instruments are made out of. Can you? That's right, metal. Not always brass, but always metal. Brass players use a mouthpiece with a little cup which goes on their lips, and they buzz their lips together like this. Can you make a sound with your lips like that? Can you buzz? Go ahead, give it a try. Very good. Brass instruments have been around for hundreds of years, and they were a favorite of kings and queens because of the regal fanfares they can play. Here's a fanfare from La Paris by French composer Ducas. Can you imagine a king or a queen or a noble family walking into a grand banquet hall when you hear this music? Thank you. Now, going from smallest to largest, we first have the trumpet. The trumpet is a very versatile instrument. It can be used in fanfares like we just heard, jazz, military bugle calls. It can sound soft or so loud that you've got to close your ears. Our principal trumpet is going to give us a little taste of how this amazing instrument sounds now. The next largest instrument in the brass family is the French horn. The horn is famous for its soaring melodies, its hunting calls, and for how it looks. It's definitely got the most curves of all of the brass family. You have to put your hand inside the bell of the horn to make a good sound. Let's hear our principal horn player give us a little demo now. Now, the reason the French horn has so many curves is the brass instrument is simply a long tube curved into a shape that we can hold. The longer the tube, the lower the sounds. The valves that you see that we use with our fingers make the tube shorter or longer, changing the pitch. So if these instruments are just long tubes with a bell and a mouthpiece, maybe it's possible to make brass instruments out of something other than metal. Let's try an experiment. Our brass section has brought some garden hoses from home today. They've strapped funnels onto the end and they've put their mouthpieces in the front. What do you think? Are we going to be able to make some music from these garden hoses? Let's give it a try. Not bad. Next time you're at Home Depot, ask your mom or dad to buy you a trumpet. Let's meet the final two members of our brass section. Up next is an instrument that doesn't have valves at all, but it uses a slide to change the pitch. When you move the slide out, it gets longer. If it gets longer, what do you think? Does the sound get higher or lower? That's right, it gets lower when you move it out. Our principal trombone is going to demo his instrument for us now. And finally, the largest member of the brass family, equivalent to the string bass in the string family or the bassoon in the woodwind family. We have the tuba. It's so big you have to rest it on your knee to play. Here is our principal tuba, who's going to demonstrate the tuba for us now. Let's hear one more piece of music featuring our brass section. Are any of you fans of Super Mario Brothers? I thought so. Then I think you're going to enjoy this one. Thank you. Okay, we've made it through our families of instruments. Quick pop quiz. Can you name all four families? Very good. Brass, woodwinds, percussion, and strings. What is the biggest and lowest brass instrument? Very good. The tuba. What is the little piece of cane called that the clarinets and oboes and bassoons put between their lips to make a sound? Very good. It's a reed. Which brass instrument gets to sometimes join the woodwind family? The French horn. What is the technique of plucking a string instead of using a bow called? I'll give you a hint. It kind of looks like something you'd put pepperoni on. Very good. Pizzicato. Thank you so much to our underwriters for making this young person's concert possible. The Benevolent and Protective Order of Elks of Lima, H&B Family Foundation, Honda of America, the Lima Rotary Foundation, Midwest Electric Company, Nutrien Potash, Paulding Putnam Electric Trust, Procter & Gamble, Rhodes State College, Wapakoneta Area Community Foundation, and we hope that each and every one of you chooses to play an instrument or sing in a choir. It's been great making music for you all, and thank you so much for tuning in to hear your Lima Symphony Orchestra. Bye-bye.